for a reaction. Good afternoon or good good afternoon, yes, Attorney Salvador.
Good afternoon to the two of you. What happened to
I'm not sure if you have been monitoring the press conference of the prosecution. Have you been hearing
their statements? Well, I've not been monitoring. I came from a meeting.
All right. Okay.
And it's only now that I took a call.
Okay. Yeah. Well, I guess give us more context of this petition for this TRO, for this preliminary injunction with the Supreme Court. It's taking a lot of people by surprise, especially with the developments yesterday. So give us the context of this one, Attorney Salvador.
I think you have to understand. Let me explain this to you this way. Kaya kahapon, hinihingi namin na kung pwede magkaroon ng motion for reconsideration bukol sa pagbubukas, the opening of bank account ng Chief Justice. Ngayon ang pinutukoy nila. Ngayon po, may kita ninyo, some of the senators mentioned that it is quite unnatural nga kung bibigyan ng motion for reconsideration. And this would be discussed as supposedly during the caucus today. But I think the defense felt that we have to face this reality that this proceeding will continue. So we filed, I think you're aware, the impeachment court number one, we filed a motion to defer in the light of a petition filed with the Supreme Court, right? So, and the matter of reception, continuation of reception of evidence of pass-up in on the position that this is still pending before the Supreme Court. So yan ang dalawang bagay na ating hinaharap, but at the same time, there is also a petition for certiorari. I think your listeners would like to know why it reached the point, okay? Why it reached the point that we have to file to the Supreme Court. If you would know, and if you have a chance to read the petition, there will be a few highlights. Number one, I think at this point in time, it is clear that the manner by which the complaint was drafted is now in question, even the transmittal thereof. Second, I think you are aware that the 2.4 provision of ill-gotten wealth was stricken down. However, I think the defense felt that despite the removal of 2.4 in their allegations, the matter of ill-gotten wealth and other sub-issues in connection with the bank deposit, which should not be discussed, is being discussed. So, that is raised also at the ground. And more importantly, I think, in connection with the bank subpoena, yung tinitingnan natin doon yung ugat, saan ba nagmula itong request ng ito? Hindi pa nga ina-actionan yung request ng impeachment court ay meron na mga dokumentong lumutang. And I think we have detailed that this is a matter of law. Ito po ay law at jurisprudence na we have to strongly consider. Kasi po, siyempre, hindi lang, let us consider it this way, no? Hindi lang po na kaso ito ng isang Chief Justice. Paano po kung may isang kaso involving any individual na sinabi dyan, eh, pwede na hong tanggapin ninyo ang inadmissible evidence kasi naman dun sa Senado po, kinonsider naman nila in the interest na malaman ang katotohanan. So this is, kailangan pong tingnan natin in that light. Hindi po that we do not respect the Senate as an impeachment court, we respect them. Alam ko po na mahirap ang kalagayan ng Senate ngayon because they are forced to look into an impeachment complaint to some extent which is incomplete. Yung pong kahapon, makita niyo po, tinanungan naman ni Senate President yan. They are in a very difficult situation. So, considering this difficulties that everyone of us is facing, so we have elevated the matter. Ang defense po yung elevate ng matter sa Supreme Court.
Right.
At kung ano man po ang resolusyon ng Supreme Court on the matter, ay gagalangin po natin.
All right. Attorney Salvador, the prosecution also noted in their press conference that they're wondering why in this petition, can you hear me now? Hello?
I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Sorry.
The prosecution also noted in their press conference, they're wondering why this petition also includes 2.3. They're saying that this has been agreed upon in the impeachment court, it's being discussed, the witnesses and the documents and the evidence have been discussed about 2.2, 2.3. It's been agreed upon that 2.4 would not be discussed, but your petition includes removal of 2.3 as well.
I think the reason why 2.3 was made a ground is that although they removed 2.4, the question on the ill-gotten wealth, even the bank records, are being introduced with 2.3 when they have removed that portion. Okay, when they have removed that portion, so lumalabas na pagtuwing pinag-uusapan, pwede ba ito tanggapin o hindi ito pwede tanggapin, sabihin, sasabi na, hindi dito yan, sa matter of reporting lang yan eh. Kung isinama o hindi sa salit. So, it is our position, yung pointing ng defense, na dapat, hindi na dapat sa binibigyan ng pagkakataong ipresenta ito. And I would want to be very clear po, no? Hindi dahil sa may kinakatakutan po rito o may itinatagong katotohanan. Siguro po, kung eventually makikita ito, ilagay natin po sa proseso, sa tamang proseso. If the Supreme Court eventually tells that it's so,
Well, interestingly as well, Attorney Salvador, that the prayer for this whole petition includes the injunction enjoining the whole proceedings before the impeachment court as well?
Well, I think that goes into the main case already. Yan ang tingin ng defense ako sa bagay na yan. And considering that it's already been filed, I think that those who are interested should look into kung ano po ang paliwanag po natin sa petition po na yan.
Okay, I mean, I'm pardon the ignorance of the legalities and the law terms, although there are specifics about 2.3, 2.4. But when you talk about asking for the injunction and joining the whole impeachment court proceedings, isn't that like akin to a shotgun approach that you're going to try to get everything bogged down and then it's up to the Supreme Court to issue the TRO to what specific they feel that would apply the best?
I think at this point in time, all that we can say is that we have filed it, and I think we have to respect all of the institution in terms of how they read the entire process.
Okay.
If, as we say, we've been fairly consistent, if they say we proceed, then we proceed. I think what we have, our people would have to consider is, kailangan po makita po nila, is kami po na may gumamit lamang ng remedyo ayon sa mata. Ngayon po, kung ito ay di-deny, wala po, tutuloy po kami.
Interestingly, do you feel that there's a possibility that the impeachment court could see the defense at risk of being cited for contempt for going to the Supreme Court?
Because this is not hindi naman po pinapas, or this is not a sign of disrespect to the impeachment court. Ito po lang is the use of the remedies available to us under the law.
Okay. And lastly, something that has been feared from the very beginning, let's say the TRO is granted and the Senate impeachment court will ignore it. Will this bring us to what has been feared as the constitutional crisis?
I don't want to give an opinion at this point in time kung ganun po, kasi hindi pa rin naman natin alam kung saan ang resolution pupunta. So what I think we have to look into now is that there is a question posted. There's a question posted before the Supreme Court, and it's still to be filed. Okay, I think this afternoon it will be filed. Then we will see what will happen.
Okay, and how soon do you expect the Supreme Court to act on this? How soon, I guess, is the defense team hoping to act on this?
We will have to leave it with the processes of the Supreme Court. So if they require us to respond, if they require us to appear, we will abide in the same manner. We complied with all of the processes required of us by the impeachment court.
All right, we want to thank you for joining us on the line, Attorney Tranquil Salvador III, spokesperson for the Corona Defense Team. Thank you, Attorney.
Salamat po. Thank you.
Dateline Philippines will come your way shortly. Stay here on ANC.